And now, okay, last period we have seen different payment structures for letter of credit. Then advantages of using letter of credit. Then risk involved in letter of credit. Then settlement of letter of credit. Okay. Then recourse in case of default. Then general document required to submit under letter of credit. Then bank's obligation and responsibilities. Okay. So advising bank responsibilities, obligations and responsibilities. Then confirming bank duties and responsibilities. Then negotiating bank duties and responsibilities. Okay. So this only we studied the last class. So different payment structures for LC. What are the different payment structures for LC? Anila, different payment structures for LC.
Acceptance credit.
Everyone turn on your video. Pavitra Ancho, Irfan Basil Atul. Different payment structures for LC.
So acceptance credit, deferred credit, revolving credit, back-to-back credit, standby letter of credit.
Okay, next advantages of using LC. Advantages of using letter of credit. Anuj? Aparna, advantages of using letter of credit. Advantages of using letter of credit. Everyone turn on your video. Pavitra, Ancho, Atul, Inna.
Sir, the beneficiary is assured of payment. As long as it complete. The credit risk is transferred from the applicant to the issuing bank.
Next, general documents required to be submitted under letter of credit. Document to be submitted under letter of credit. Aditya, everyone turn on your video. Okay, so now bank guarantee and the letter of credit is over. Bank guarantee and the letter of credit, it is over. Now selling third party products. Selling third party products. So fee-based product, it is over. fee-based services, bank guarantee, and letter of credit. Then difference between a letter of credit, it is over. So next one is selling third-party products. Selling third-party products. So in that you will study insurance and the mutual fund. Okay. Okay, selling third-party products. That is the next topic. Selling third-party products. So it is come under syllabus selling third-party products, insurance and mutual fund units. Okay. So here we are getting commission on selling other companies' product, not our product. So already we said that the main sources of income for banking company is getting interest. Okay. Interest is the main income of the banking company. So here means they are getting commission, they are getting amount on selling other companies' product, means third party's product. Okay. So it is considered as a new source of revenue for a business. Okay, new source of income for a banking company. Okay. Otherwise, main operation is that accepting deposit from the public and giving loan to the public. Okay. So through that, if they get any income, that is main activities. Here means third party product. They are getting income by selling selling other companies' product. That is which one? Selling third party product. Okay. But the amount that they get from the customer is very small, but they will make a valuable contribution to get revenue. Okay, that is related to selling third party product. Okay, so in that we will study the insurance and the mutual fund. Insurance and the mutual fund. Okay, selling third party product, in that we will study insurance and mutual fund. So here one thing you have to remember, here we are selling other companies' product. Banks sell other companies' product. That if they get any income, that is their source of income. The bank's source of income. So here, what do you mean by mutual fund? So already we studied mutual fund. So you look at that, it is an investment vehicle that pools the money of large group of investors and invest in a variety of securities to achieve specific investment objective. So that is which one? Mutual fund means it is an investment that brings together, that collects money from many people and invest in stock, bonds or other assets. That is mutual fund. Okay, that is mutual fund. Okay, so it is operated by the professional money manager. We can tell portfolio manager or asset manager or investment manager. So these mutual funds, what they are doing, they are collecting amount from the public. Mutual fund, you can so you can see in the advertisement, you can see that mutual fund, what they are doing, they will collect money from the public and invest in the good securities, in that they will get more profit. Okay, means they attempt to produce capital gains or income for the funds investors. Okay, so that is mutual fund. So it gives access to the individual investor or small investor to deposit amount in the securities, to purchase shares at a low price. They will help. Okay. So it is managed by the professionally managed people. What people, portfolio manager, asset manager, investment manager, we can tell that person's name. So we are, the banks sells, which one, the portfolio managers services. Okay. So that for that they will get a commission. So portfolio managers, what they are doing, they will employ the people with various expertise. Okay, so what they will do, what is their work? So they will appoint the specialist. Then the specialist work is to do the research and selection of the which one, shares, monitoring the shares. Then they will decide when to sell the shares. So every time they will monitor the value of the shares. So on that basis, they will decide whether to sell or to buy the share. Clear? So they will invest in that. Then they will decide where to invest, in which company share we have to purchase. Okay? So we are investing in lot of shares, lot of companies shares. So it is risky also, but sometimes it will get more profit also. Okay? That is about which one, a mutual fund. Okay? This is an investment that brings together the money from the many people and invest in stock, bond, or other assets. That is which one? Mutual funds. That is mutual funds. Clear, no? So one thing you have to remember. So just that is which one? Mutual fund. Mutual fund. So mutual fund means an investment. It is an investment that brings together the money from many people and investment in stocks, bonds, or other assets. Okay, it is managed by the professionally money managers, portfolio manager. So their work, they will closely monitor the each company's share, then they will invest amount in that share. Then whenever the price is very high, the share value is high, then that day they will sell their shares. That is mutual fund. Okay, that is about the mutual fund. Next one, insurance. Insurance. So what do you mean by insurance? You're in this book, you're nothing, they specified. They specified only life insurance product and not types of insurance only, they specified. So what do you mean by insurance? So insurance is an agreement between the insurance between the two parties. It is an agreement between two parties. Party's name is insurance company and the individual. Okay. So insurance is an agreement between the two parties. Insurance is an agreement between two parties. The name is insurance company. That person is insurance company is known as insurer. Okay. It is a legal agreement between two parties. Means the insurance company and the individual. So individual is known as insured. Okay. It is the legal agreement between the insurance company and the insured. Okay. Insurer means insurance company. Insured means the person who took the insurance policy. Okay. So here, what they are doing in this case, the insurance company promises to make good the losses of the insured. Okay. Here means the insurance company promises to make good the losses of the company, losses of the insured on the happening of the insured contingency. On the happening of the insured contingency. So what do you mean by contingency? It is the event which causes losses. It is the event which causes losses. Sometimes it will be related to the life, otherwise it will be related to the property. Okay, that is insurance. Okay, this is an agreement between insurance company and the insured. Then here means the insurance company promises to make good the losses of the insured. Okay, to make good the losses of the insured. Also of the insured. So the contingency on the happening of the insured contingency means contingency means it is the event which causes a loss. So contingency means it can be the death or the destruction of the property. Okay, destruction of the property, damage or destruction of the property. Okay, So why it is called a contingency? Because there is an uncertainty regarding the happening of the event. So loss by fire, it is uncertainty. Sometimes it won't happen. So why it is called there is an uncertainty regarding the happening of the event. Okay. So for compensating the loss of the insured pays a premium. Okay. The insured, here the insured pays a premium. Insured, the insurance holder, insured pays a premium. Premium they have to pay. Then only they will get a insurance policy in return for the promise made by the insurer. In return for the promise made by the insurer. Promise made by the insurer. Okay, the insured pays a premium in return for promise made by the insurer. So this is which one now? Insurance. So it is a contract between insurance company and the individual or the insurer and the insured. So here the company promises to compensate the losses in the event of contingency. Okay. So it can be the death of a person or damage or destruction of the property. Okay. Damage or destruction of the property. So here for compensating the loss, who will give the premium? The insured will give the premium to the insurance company. Okay. That is about insurance. Clear note? So insurance is an agreement between the insurance company and the insured. Here the company promises to make good the losses of the company. That is about insurance. Now we will discuss types of insurance. Okay, types of insurance. So life insurance products, non-life insurance products. Okay, two types of insurance. Life insurance and non-life insurance. Okay, so you have no need to study full, only these are the topic. Okay, meaning of insurance it is not given, so I will give. So life insurance product, what do you mean by life insurance? Means a contract. It is a contract between the insurance company and the insured only. Here it is a contract to pay a specified sum on the expiry of the policy, on the expiry of the policy, or on the death of the insurer, whichever is earlier. Now example, so I took the LIC policy, life insurance policy. I took the life insurance policy. So which on quarterly I am giving 1500 quarterly. Okay, so the sum 20 year period. Okay, period is 20 year. So payment amount is after 20 year I will get 2 lakh. That only the amount, sum assured is 2 lakh. So yearly 6,000 I have to pay. Okay, 6,000. I took the life insurance policy from LIC. So I am paying 1,500 per quarter. Okay, per quarter I am giving. So what is the benefit? So it is a contract to pay specified sum. Specified sum means 2 lakh on the expiry of the policy. Means after 20 year, I will get 2 lakh from LIC. Clear? That is the first point. Or on the death of the insured. Or on the death of the insured, whichever is earlier. Suppose, now I took the insurance policy. So after 1 month, if I die, means that 2 lakh amount. So I paid only, suppose after 3 months, I died. So only I paid 1,500. But my family, my nominee, they will get 2 lakh from the LIC, 2 lakh from the company. So then they won't need to pay any amount extra next no need of any other installment. They have to pay to the insurance company, so they will get, that is life insurance. Okay, so why we are taking life insurance? It is not a, so the insurance we can't use for a source of profit. For profit point of view, we can't use this one. Okay, it is a protection to the family, protection to us and for our family. Okay, so medical insurance means for protecting us. Okay, for which one? Pension policy for protecting us and for protecting our family. LIC means for protecting us and for protecting our family. Right? They also no problem. Okay, so they will get the nominee will get the amount. That is life insurance. Whichever is earlier, death or 20 years. Which one is best earlier? That is which one? Life insurance. Clear? Life insurance policy. Life insurance policy. So this LICs, but the banks also, which one? Banks also dealing this one LIC. You can see that a bank, HDFC LIC, HDFC insurance policy. So every bank they used to do. So that is which one? Third party products. Okay, no. So that is life insurance. Life insurance. Here the bank earned revenue through the selling of the life insurance policy on behalf of the insurance company. So the contract of insurance is between the insurer and the insured. Okay, here means contract is what? Insurer and the insured. Company and the individual only, not between the bank and the insured. Because we are selling the third party products only. Here contract is between the insurer and the insured. Okay, then one thing you have to remember, it is not a contract of indemnity. It is not a contract of indemnity. Which one? Life insurance policy. Life insurance policy. So what do you mean by which one? Contract of indemnity. What do you mean by indemnity? Means the insured will get only the actual amount of loss, not exceeding the amount of policy. Okay. What do you mean by indemnity? That you have no need to study, you have to remember. So what do you mean by indemnity? Means the insured will get only the actual amount of policy. The insured will get only the actual amount of loss. Will get only the actual amount of loss. Not exceeding the amount of policy. Okay, the insured will get only the actual amount of loss, not exceeding the amount of policy. What it means? Suppose if it example, loss of goods by fire. We took the insurance policy for loss of goods by fire. So insurance policy amount is 50,000. Okay, so we took the insurance policy for what purpose? Loss by fire, covering the loss of goods by fire. So amount of policy is 50,000. Next, so then fire happened in the godown. Then the insurance company will come. Then they will check the stock. So the actual loss, if it is 30,000, then the policy holder, how much they will get? 50,000 or 30,000. We took the insurance policy for rupees 50,000, but for covering the loss for covering the loss of goods by fire, but actual loss is only 30,000. So how much insurance company will give to the policy holder? 50 or 30? That is this point, indemnity. The insured will get only the actual amount of loss. So actual amount of loss is how much?
30,000.
Okay. So actual amount of loss, 30,000. So policy holder will get 30,000. Suppose actual amount of loss is 60,000. Actual amount of loss is 60,000. So how much payment they will get? 60 or 50? That point is there, no? You can tell. Shubham, how much they will get? Insurance policy 50,000. Actual loss is 60,000.
50,000.
50 or 60?
60,000.
Anyone? 50 or 60?
50,000.
50, no? 50,000. I can't hear anything. I don't know whether you are telling answer or not.
So 60,000.
Now I can't remember. I can't hear anything. So 50,000 only they will get. That is this point. The insured will get only the actual amount of loss, not exceeding the amount of policy. Amount of policy is 50,000. Actual loss is 60,000. Okay. So the insured will get, because that's why we are telling that it is not taken as say so-so profit. For getting profit, we can't utilize insurance policy. Okay. So that is this one. But what I am telling, life insurance policy is not a contract of indemnity. Because if you look at that life insurance policy, the insured will get only the actual amount of those. Suppose I can't tell, no, Femina, so your amount is 10 lakh. Aparna, 20 lakh. Aditya, 30 lakh. Shubham Pal, 50 lakh. Anila Mohan, 1 crore. Abdurrahman, 10 rupees. Okay, really, no? So we'll get only the actual amount of those. Really, we can't tell that. Okay, is it correct, no? Shubham?
Sir, I don't have that much.
Okay, so that is which one? So that's why life insurance is not a contract of indemnity. Okay, so if we ask our parent, they will tell our value. Okay, so next, that is which one? Life insurance product. So that is life insurance product. Next one, non-life insurance products. So types of insurance, I said life insurance and non-life insurance. It is also known as, we can tell another name for non-life insurance product, general insurance. General insurance. Okay, general insurance. Or otherwise, property insurance. Okay, property insurance. General insurance, property insurance. That is also which one? Non-life insurance. Example of non-life insurance, which one? Car insurance, health insurance, education insurance, home insurance. Okay. So the losses that are incurred from a specific financial event are compensated to the insured. This is called non-life insurance. It is not related to the life. So other all insurance, that is general insurance, non-life insurance. Okay, marine insurance. Okay, ship. So if example, if you are importing goods from other, so if you are taking marine insurance, then damage is covered from fire, theft, calamities, travel insurance. Okay, then online breach incident related to cyber security. Okay, so these are the general insurance. So it is a contract of indemnity. It is a contract of indemnity. Okay, it is why it is a contract of indemnity. Here means the insured will get only the actual amount of loss, not exceeding the amount of policy. So that's why it is a, which one, non, which one, it is a contract of indemnity. But life insurance, we can't tell that that which one some people value. Okay, so if anyone ask our value, means we will tell more, we will push more, but so we can't tell. So but non-life insurance products are, it is a contract of indemnity. You look, sir, this is a general insurance which includes automobile, home owners policies, fire insurance, medical insurance. So it general insurance generally comprises any insurance that is not a life insurance. It may safeguard any property from any casualty insurance also there. The contract of insurance is between the insurer and the insured, not between the bank and the insured, same like a life insurance product. Okay, so if example, if you take that which one insurance, then you have to study each insurance for what purpose we are using. Car insurance, okay, for protecting the life of the each one, for protecting accident, health insurance, education insurance, home insurance, okay, marine insurance, damage from fire, theft. Then if example, if our employees make any stealing from the business, so for that purpose also we can take insurance policy. Okay, so these are the non-life insurance products. Okay, non-life insurance product. So insurance, types of insurance. Insurance means it is a contract between, it is a contract between insurance company, insurer and the insured. Here insurance company promises to make good the losses of the insured on the happening of certain perils, certain contingencies. Okay, contingency means uncertainty. This uncertain contingency is uncertain. Okay, next we studied life insurance. Life insurance means a contract to pay a specified sum on the expiry of the policy after 20 year or on the death of the insurer, whichever is earlier. Normally majority of the people, they won't take which one life insurance policy, because now if they die, what they that amount they who will only get it? The nominee only will get it. Okay, so if they don't like that nominee means, okay, they will not take LIC. Okay, so that is which one, life insurance. Next one, non-life insurance. So it is a general insurance policy. It is a contract between the insurer and the insured only. So here means promises to make good the loss of the insured only on the happening of certain contingencies. So that is which one, non-life insurance. Same you can tell means meaning. So okay, so that is about types of insurance. Today I taught only which one, mutual fund to selling third party products. Mutual fund, so it is an investment that brings money from that collect money from the people and invest in the good securities. That is mutual fund. It is managed by the professionally managed people. Okay, so they are every time they are monitoring the indexes, stock indexes. On that basis they will deal the securities, they will sell and they will buy. So life insurance, then insurance, then the types of insurance, life insurance and non-life insurance product. Okay, so now time is over.